Sid Snot here. You know, the last series was such a steaming success that Lord Thames decided to award this lovely thing here to Kenny Everett for services rendered. I think that's very nice. I mean, the fact he didn't give me one doesn't make me annoyed. I am not annoyed in the slightest bit that he didn't give it to me. He gave it to that putz instead. I am not annoyed. I think it's very nice. I think it's lovely. What do you call these things? Oh, yeah. Bust.
Hello. This is your television speaking. Behind your screen, deep amongst the valves and transistors, preparations have been going on for yonks, for this blamaroody new series of video shows. All these fabulous stars have been rehearsing right here in the dusty recesses of your television set. So, before you can say, we present the Kenny Everett video show. Let's push the button marked idiot and see what comes out.
Hi, viewers, and welcome to part one, show one, series two. And what a fab series it's going to be. We've slashed out, if you'll pardon the expression, and bought tons of new scenery. Look at it. Doesn't it look great? Looks great from up here, too. Looks quite good from here, too. What does it look like from where you are? Tell you what, rush into the kitchen and see what it looks like from there, okay? Tell you what, crew, while they're away, let's watch Hot Gossip. Sid Snot here.
Well?
Lord Thames, in all his impotent wisdom, has decided to send another bus there. Can't wait for the next one.
Hello. When I grow up, I'm going to be Kenny Everett. Pathetic, isn't it?
Do friends turn pale when you exhale? When you speak, do your lips run for cover? Does your nose close at your prose? Then you've got a secret, and your secret is bad breath!
When you're walking down the street, do the people that you meet turn away and look so sad just because your breath is bad? Try Stench Away.
Yes, we at Stench Away can bring you the sweet smell of success. Stench Away is not a cream, not a pill, not a lotion. It's a simple scientific aid that'll help you keep what few friends you have left. Yes, Stench Away will cure your bad breath condition, or as we like to call it, BBC. Yes, Stench Away with improved tonic vitamins, or as we like to call them, ITV.
Get rid of BBC and switch to ITV today with Stench Away.
Yes, Stench Away sprays your words as they leave your mouth and freshens them up. Also kills 99% of all known germs and dirty words, rearranging them into a well-known phrase or saying. Completely undetectable and easy to wear. Get Stench Away today.
Try Stench Away.
Hello. Here I am, riding around inside Tony Blackburn's brain. Looks like it was designed by Frank Lloyd Wrong. Actually, I got this wonderful idea that if I drove around in this scenery for a while, I would get a great idea for an opening line into the next item. But I didn't.
Have you got yourself an occupation?
All of us are here to stay. All of us are on their way. And I would rather be anywhere else but today.
There was a check on Charlie. He didn't crack a smile. But it's no laughing parted when you've been on the murder mile. Only takes one itch to trigger, one more widow, one less white nigger.
All of us are here to stay. All of us are on their way.
Just the waiting, Mr. Churchill's here. If you're out.
was quite good, that, for a part one. In fact, I thought it was one of the great part ones of our time. I particularly liked the bit that went,
"Look, up in the sky!"
And this bit wasn't bad either. The best bit was,
"Leader of the opposition and possibly..."
What do you mean you never saw those bits? I saw them. You haven't been watching properly. Right, for that you can just stay in, fill the inkwells, and watch part two.
And now, Intercontinental Ballistic Enterprises present an associated multinational production.
Captain Krennan.
The world's most fabulous man.
Hi, kids. Welcome to episode 2, series 5, volume 9, part 6, book 1 of an adventure so bold and staggering, it makes Star Wars look like a Tony Blackburn home movie. And now, space fans and holders of identicards, here's the story so far.
You remember last time, a whole bunch of things happened. And if you missed that episode, you're in big trouble, because now it's this time.
On the bridge of the Trawl One, heading out into the inky blackness of space once more. Stardate 49-384.
Hi, Captain. I brung you some hot bovril full of beefy goodness.
That's Carla. She's my right arm. Shaped a little better.
Well, Carla, here we are at the bridge of my mighty nuclear-powered spaceship again, thrusting forward.
That last adventure was so terrific. You'll have to go some to beat it this time.
Carla, this is no joyride. The boss says things are too quiet out here in space, and that's always a sign of danger.
Hi, Captain.
Hi, Gonad.
How's it going up here on the bridge?
Well, it's a bit quiet at the moment. How are things down in the crew's quarters?
Well, most of the crew are asleep.
Asleep?
Yeah. The Max Bygrave show's on television.
Plastic Max, huh?
Yeah.
Here, take this videotape and watch it instead.
Oh, what is it?
It's the entire history of the whole world, with all the nasty bits taken out.
How long does it run?
About 27 seconds.
I'll get it, Captain. Hello, to whom am I speaking at? Oh, it's for you, Captain.
Tar, hello?
Hi, Captain. Spock here. We're having a little trouble with the generator.
Oh? What kind of trouble?
Well, for no apparent reason, we're losing power.
Well, space fans, it's only episode 1, but our trusty crew are up against it already. Find out how they escape in the next fab adventure of Captain Krennan.
Here we are in the Gold Digger's Coolies for another little drinky-poo. Shut 'em up, Joe! Oh, Fandangle. Tell you what, instead of the booze, we'll have the boo-zooms. And who better to dangle them in front of you than Miss Kitty? Here she comes! Hey, Kitty, Kitty! Say, you just don't look the same since the operation. Still, give us a kiss.
Hello, my little broccoli spears. I was just talking to one of those naughty hot gossip ladies, tete-a-tete, and I mean that, you know? And she told me that they practice all those super naughty writhings and movings they do. I said, could I be their coach? And she said, yes, we will put seats in your mouth. What a spirited lady. Au revoir, my gherkins.
Hello. This is the show that thumped Leo Sayer and belted Rod Stewart. We just can't let a megastar go, but today we've got the all-ever-lovely, twinkly-eyed David Essex, so we thought we'd interview him, and here it is. David, I can't tell you what a pleasure it is to have you appear on my show, and I hear that you have a new record out.
Yes.
I hear it's really great.
Drink.
And not only that, but it's called The Imperial Wizard, too.
Yes.
You're known as an actor and a singer. Now, these are very different activities. Do you prefer one to the other?
No. Fuck it.
David, a personal question now. Do you intend to drop that bucket of water on me?
Yes.
Thank you.
Hello, my little bonbons. You know, darlings, I was watching those naughty hot gossipings, and they remind me so much of our own naughty can-can ladies back in Paris. Ah, Paris, home of the Eiffel Tower, that great Gallic symbol. Naughty Marcel, what have I said? Au revoir, my fish fingers.
Hello. Mouth on a stick here. The following program isn't half as bad as some of the muck you've been getting lately. In fact, it's a bit of a wheeze, really.
But for those of you who can't stop in for the whole thing, here's the speeded-up version.
And now,
before you can say... It's the video show. Let's push the button marked idiot and see what comes out.
Hello, and welcome to Show 2, Part 1, Series 2, Sheffield Wednesday 3. You know, after last week's show, millions of people wrote in saying it was so great that we could never follow it. Well, we did follow it. And you know where it went. It went to a gay bar in Soho, where it had a drinky-poo with Magpie and then left with News at 10. And now...
Running wild in the...
mum says she uses toilet water. I tried it the other day and the seat fell on me head. All right. These jokes are new to me.
Hello, everybody. Search suit here with some more Jenny poos concerning the revolution and the far-reaching changes we'll be carrying out in this country. By the way, the revolution has been postponed due to Rod Stewart's dandruff, but we'll be keeping you posted. Anyway, there'll be some changes in your reactionary bourgeois calendar when we come to power. Christmas Day will become Lenin Day. Boxing Day will become Brezhnev Day, and Lena Zavaroni will become Doris Day. Whip crack away, whip crack away, whip crack away. Power to the people, but mostly power to me.
Slip and slide.
Brother Nina.
It makes this brother feel good inside.
Brother Nina.
Keep playing it on this laid-back cat.
Brother Nina.
I wish my watch had a movement like that.
Brother Nina.
Cause I want to tell you that it's gonna be
welcome to these filthy heaps called videotapes. Here, encrusted in these filth-stenched remains, are the old remnants of old programs and shows and commercials, one of which we're going to show you today. Empty poos. On to the next one. This is something from Australia, and this is quite serious, actually. This is a serious commercial that's actually going out at this very moment all over Australia. It's a subtle little number. Watch this.
It's a bargain! Come!
Another shattering announcement from Buck Off Bills.
Now, Pop, this for the first time in Australian beer history, a Buck Off all the best-selling brands of just about everything. Scotch a Buck Off Johnny Walker, Brandy a Buck Off Chatel, Gin a Buck Off Gordon's, Bacardi a Buck Off, Vodka Smirnoff a Buck Off. Wine, all settled, 10% off. Beer, courage, over 2.5 bucks off, only $7.99 for 30 dozen. Plus, me own Uncle Bill's wines and spirits. Now, cop it again. A Buck Off all these spirits. Johnny Walker, Chatel Brandy, Gordon's Gin, Bacardi, Smirnoff Vodka. Beer, courage, over 2.5 bucks off on $7.99 for 2 dozen. Plus me own Uncle Will's wines and spirits, including my own Uncle Will's black label 5-year-old scotch at $6.12. Hurry, it's a first-in, first-out cop. In the north, St. Leonard's, Mossman, Brookvale, Churchwood, Forestville, Eastwood, Mount Cola. In the south, Punsall, Mount Darby, South Liverpool. In the east, Paddington and Maroubra. Up the west, at Enfield, Westmeath and Katoomba.
Cute, huh? Anybody want to buy an empty spool box? There's a Buck Off. Hello. I've been watching the Kenny Everett video show. And it's terrible. And yet, wonderful. Wonderful in its terror and terrible in its wonder. Nothing. And yet, its very nothingness is redolent of something. But what is that something? Is Everett surely the first media terrorist trying to tell us that nothingness is everything and everything is nothing? I think so. And yet...
Hello, folks. Gonna have a little get-together now here. We've got the cucumber sandwiches and the Maori biscuits and the tea. And we're gonna throw a little party. Gonna throw it over there, and then when we've mashed it up and scrunched it into a crun, we're gonna throw it over there. And now, doing GBH on a nice, inoffensive little number, Dave Edmonds and a rock pile!
Cause I held
and spiffing tune by a delicious duo, and we wish it well in the charts and all that DJ drivel. But hold hard. We haven't thumped a superstar. Bring me David Essex and hit him with a pie. Thank you.
Arr, tumble my weeds and bow my weevils. Fine. Well, ladies and gentlemen, here we are in the Rustler's Rump for another drink. Keep on. Set him up, Joe. Oh, spinneroo. Hey, tell you what, folks. Rustle my weed and yee-haw! Tumble my weeds and ball my weevils. Here we are in the panhandler's piles, waiting for a drinky-poo. Set him up, Joe. Dread-a-roo. Tell you what, I'll forego my usual butch brew, and I'll have a Harvey Wallbanger. Thanks, Harvey.
Hey, baby, where's the beach? Lead me to that beautiful breaker. Then I'll fly. Who needs Freddy Laker? I can dig that.
Commercial time.
Hi, disco fans. Get out your boogie boots and get ready for a big new one. Yes, this is it. Rip-Off proudly presents Fuzzy Throw's all-time golden disco greats. Dig this! They're all here on Percy's big allotments of hits. Are they, darling? Yes, they certainly are. Dip your dibber in these. Hit me with your digging stick. Pitchfork shovel, hothouse rock. Get the pansies in the bed. Baby, lay your bulbs on me. I can't get no pollination. Prune it till you're satisfied. Keep on plowing. Compost holiday. I lost my spay to a greenhouse reaper. Yes, all these and more. Boogie down to your store now. The Percy Thrower's Golden Disco Greats. Available at Woolworths, Tilly White's, WH Smith, Army and Navy Stores, Mother Cow, the London Zoo, the Norfolk Broads, Charma Groats, Morrish Nosh Bar, Harrods, and all reputable trees everywhere. Percy Thrower's Golden Disco Greats. Get it now. Get it? Right? Right.
You know, I had a lot of fun making this record. I hope you enjoy listening to it.
Hello. Am I wrong in thinking that Everett is angry and yet an oasis of peace in the media maelstrom? Peaceful in his anger and yet frighteningly angry in his peacefulness? The cowboy at the bar, for instance, in his endless, fruitless quest for a drink, is surely every man, and yet, in a very real way, no man at all. The very nihilistic prototype that we fear, and yet love, and yet... What cobblers?
Hello. Margaret Thatcher here. I want you, during these troubled times, to look as worried as I do. Hello. I know you at home, because I'm one too. And you're sitting there thinking, when's Harry Webb coming on? Now!
Here is a message for dum-dums. Harry Webb is Cliff Richard's real name.
Searching for a green light, looking for it all night, using all my keen sight, searching for a green light, from just this side of midnight, till dawn breaks into daylight, keeping myself out of sight. Searching for a green light.
long since you gave me a sign. A sign to stop my head turning. But all I have are just your old memories. But you know, baby, searching for a green light from just this side of midnight,
just this side of midnight,
till dawn breaks into daylight, keeping myself out of sight,
searching,
searching for a green light.
A spiffing tune. I'd like to thank my guests, Laura Norder, Benny Fischel, Carrie Erbag, and Dick Tater. Don't forget to tune in next week to find out whether Dora Jar and her cohort Betty Doesn't will escape from the piranha-filled envelope in which they've been sealed by the evil Count von 1 to 10 and his fiendish assistants, Ken Woodmixer and Ivor Hernia. As ever, we leave you with a cliffhanger.
Oh! Shut up! Shut up!
Hello, my little oven-ready chickens. You know, they have given me my own dressing room on this show, and it's next door to the one hot gossip ladies use. I have bored a little hole in the wall. I let them watch me. Oh, macho Marcel. Au revoir, my beef burgers.
My daddy's brought me a cellophane nappy so he can see what's going on. The way I tell him.
You're tuned to the Kenny Everett Video Show. Tra-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la. Amen.
And now, Spots Before Your Ears Productions bring you...
Ladies and gentlemen, here is an important announcement. On this show, we've had all sorts of fabulous international personalities and the creme de la creme of British pop stars. We've had superstars even, and megastars like Rod, who we did this with. Now, we bring you a star of such mega magnitude, you won't believe it. Ladies and gentlemen, Billy the Dancing Bucket! Well, Billy, do your stuff. Thank you, bucket lovers everywhere. Thank you, I love you. Oh!
Hello, Sid Snot here. I've got a new bird, real Debbie number, you know what I mean? Says, absolutely.
when all she means is bleeding yes. Calls me a bit of rough, says I'm uncouth. I mean, where does she get off thinking that? I took her to the ballet, you know, to the opera, took her to a real play. And what she mean, bleeding uncouth? Yeah, you know, in ballet, they all walk about on their toes all the time. Beats me why he didn't get taller people in the first place.
You're late!
Where'd you put your Chewy in Thames television? Hello, welcome to the video vault. No, it's naughty that. Ooh. Oh, God. Oh. You know how we usually have loads of fun and laughs in here watching daft old clips? Well, today, it's more your sort of documentary pool. You know, we've all got to start somewhere in life. Well, here's where this famous star started.
Take jobs on the edges of show business.
This is the first car I ever owned. I call her Cynthia. She's going to have the best care a car ever has. Put Royal Triton in Cynthia's little tummy.
Right, ladies.
Cynthia will just love that Royal Triton.
There you go, Marilyn Monroe in her first ever screen role. Even in a tatty old commercial, she still shone through with that Marilyn Monroe-ness. Now, where's that dirty mark? Ah, that's better.
Hello, you remember me. I used to be Kate Bush.
Commercial time.
Hello. Are you small? Are you minimal, infinitesimal, microscopic, tiny, wee, diddy, minute, diminutive, miniature, undersized, meager, puny, scant, scarce, petty, paltry, insignificant, small? Do you realize that's the biggest speech on smallness ever made? Incredible as it may seem, I too used to be small. Ever since I was so high, I was so high. My only close friend was the ground. Stepping on a weighing machine gave me a nosebleed. I was driven to subterfuge. I resorted to deceit. When friends came to call, I would make them walk in a trench. Being down was getting me down. Small began to pall. But what to do? What to do? Then a friend recommended Mighty Boots.
Do you wish that you were ever so tall?
Oh, yeah.
Do you want to rise above them all?
Uh-huh.
Do you want the world to have to look up at you?
Mm-hmm.
I'll tell you what you gotta do.
Try Mighty Boots.
Mighty Boots. Inconspicuous, undetectable. Even those closest to you will have no idea you're wearing them. Look the world in the face again. Greet your friends on upper floors. Send now for your pair of Mighty Boots to this address. Kenny Everett Mighty Boots offer, Thames Television, near England. And remember, friends, height is right. Tall is all. Get them now. Mighty Boots.
They're obscene. Hey, Bobbery Bob and all those other ad-lib bits. It's gonna be all right.
Hey, baby, where's the beach? Where's the beach, alas, alack? Show me a wave, and I'll wave back. I can dig that.
Hello. This is my glamorous set here. The director doesn't know I'm going to do this. Come with me. Over here. Over here. This way. Dratty boy. I bet you thought this was the height of glamour, Thames TV, didn't you? Well, look at this. Filthy tea towels. Dirty old stained drinks. Hollywoodsville. Oh. A bit of the old unexpected there. But let me tell you this. We're going to show you a hairy old rock act now. Do you feel ready for it? Let's give you the 2-second test. All right. You coped. Wonderful. Have another one. Okay, have a couple of anodyne, and maybe you can stand the whole thing.
And now, the video show is proud to bring you Thin Lizzy.
Valentino got a bookie shop. What he takes, he gives for what he's got. What he's got, he says he has not stole off anyone. It's not that he don't tell the truth, or even that he misfunctions you. It's just he holds the proof, but you know something's wrong.
Waiting for an alibi,
waiting for an alibi,
yeah, just to get you.
Waiting for an alibi,
waiting for an alibi.
Valentino's in a cold sweat, wasted all his money on that last beer. Against all the odds, he smokes another cigarette. Says it helps him to forget that he's another sweat. It's not that he misses much, or even that he lost his lucky touch. It's just he gambled too much, and you know that it's wrong.
Waiting for an alibi,
waiting for an alibi.
Waiting for an alibi,
waiting for an alibi.
Wait just to get ya.
I'm being taught a lesson by Lord Thames. He doesn't want me to touch his bloody cameras. I was going to bring you the secret of life, but it's over there and I can't get to it.
Good evening and welcome to the Palm Court of the Regency Hotel here in what we like to call Ashton and a Line. And it's time now for our weekly tea dance. Here for your dancing pleasure are Mr. Presley Holly and Spit.
Better things to do.
Spots Before Your Ears Productions bring you
the speeded up version. Before you can say Tamata Wakatangi Hangiguayu, Tamataya Tulipuka, Kapikimonga, Horanukuboka, Wenawakatanatahu, Matakuaitanganurukawa Mikitora. It's the video show.
You know, I think it's about time we had a cozy little chat. A real cozy number, you know, like we did in the last series. Millions of you wrote in saying, what the hell was I doing? A bit more cozy. Hello. Right, that's enough of this slushy intimate stuff. Back to your sofas. Oh, by the way, did you see last week's show? Wasn't it wonderful? Unfortunately, incomplete, though. We left a bit out. This bit.
Look, up in the sky!
Not one of the all-time great bits, but it was hanging around, getting in everyone's way, and now it isn't. Oh, by the way, did you see that magazine last week? They've got a new invention for television. It's for performers who say irritating things and annoy viewers. What happens is, this device picks up the negative vibrations from the insulted viewers involved, transmits them to the studio, which triggers off a device which strangles the performer. Thank heavens I never say silly, irritating things like...
And now, Brian Ferry!
No, it's not you!
That. I meant darts! You can edit it together at home.
Today. Nothing! This morning, I spilled coffee all down my wife's nightdress. Serves me right for wearing it.
Women of the Star Corps.
This week starring Phyllis Stein, Molly Kuhl, and Willie Eckerslake in episode 426. Here's Kremen.
Thank you. Hi, kids. Mr. Fantastic here, and here's my sexy assistant, Carla. Hi, Carla. You're looking even more beautiful today.
Thanks, Captain. I've been in a voluptutron.
Great. Shall we start this week's cereal? Good idea. You remember on the last video show, I decided the best course of action would be to zoom over to Washington and hold a meeting of all the world powers to once and for all put an end to the giant banana. We left the main ship dangling in space and took off in the shuttlecraft towards America. Thousand miles later on.
I just can't help feeling we've forgotten something, you know.
Something like what, oh heavily endowed buddy?
Well, I don't know. I remembered the space tan lotion and the anti-galaxy sickness pills. Mm-hmm.
Well, did you remember the traveler's checks?
Sure did.
Well, then we have everything we need.
Captain!
What?
I just realized what's missing.
What is?
We came without the crew.
You're right. Every spaceship needs a crew. Well,
thank heavens I brought this.
She rummaged around in her space bag.
Here we are.
Thanks. What is it? Dehydrated instant crew. Just add water. Okay.
Gee, I hope this works, Carla.
So do I.
As we watched, suddenly it began. Out of the tin came a first mate, engineer, navigator, and sundry assorted personnel.
Golly, it's hell in that tin.
Hi, men.
Hi, Captain.
Go about your duties, men.
Yeah. Sure thing. Hey.
Gee, Carla, thank heavens you remember the instant crew.
Yeah, my memory's one of my good points.
She hitched up the other two and made off to the galley.
I'll just go fix us some victuals now.
Okay. Hours passed by as we zoomed through the inky blackness.
Wake up! Look! Up there on the screen!
Oh, what?
Oh! Meine Wunderblatt! Gott in Himmel geschachtige Spitzenblumedang!
Yes, at last we've arrived! Take the controls, Doc! I leapt down to the galley where Carla was leaning over the hot plate looking like a relief map of the Himalayas.
Hi, Carla.
Hi, Captain.
Why are you gasping?
Well, it says on this packet here, to open... tear around the edge.
Anyway, I just came to tell you we've arrived. I tuned my wrist TV into the United Nations, where I was gonna give my speech, and noticed they were already in session. It was then I decided that the giant banana was yet another job I was gonna have to tackle alone.
You've just suffered through a disgusting episode of Fremen of the Star Corps.
And now, my little cheese and onion crisps. In one of those unforgivable ladies in the hot gossip is a religious maniac, I think. You know, she told me she has a divine right. Her left is pretty good, too, no? Au revoir, my little Eccles cakes.
Okay, it's close intimate bit now. A friend of mine just came back from the States recently and brought this with him. He found it in a supermarket. I thought you might like it. It's called potato toppers. It's sprinkly stuff you put over spuds. And the contents are hilarious. Look, contains chives, parsley, onions, herbs, spices, and natural smoked imitation bacon bits. The thing is, you sprinkle it over your spud and you pretend it's good. And talking of good, here are the pretenders. A tenuous little link.
It is time for you to stop all the sobbing. Yes, it's time for you to stop all of your sobbing. Oh, oh. There's one thing you gotta do to make me still want you.
Gotta stop sobbing now. Gotta stop sobbing now.
Yeah, stop. It is.
camera. Hello! Saved!
Gone and the ads are done.
Brother Lilo.
And now it's part two, you sons of a gun.
Brother Lilo.
Wonder how good it's gonna be.
Brother Lilo.
Well, it better be good, cause there's no part three.
Brother
Lilo. Well, I tell all you naff Nancy's, nothing personal, you understand. It's gonna be
Disco version here. The trouble with that damn white hunky brotherly love, he ain't got no rhythm like what I has got. Hit me with your rhythm stick. Ah! Oh, I see stars. I see Sammy Davis Jr., Stevie Wonder, Brian Ferry. What's that damn white hunky doing in my dream?
It's Brian Ferry and Roxy Music with Trash.
What trash, no doubt?
Are you customized or ready-made? Heavy metal, drink or treat? Uh-huh. Only 17. On the level, trash is neat. Teenage fever, oh, you've got it bad. Caught the flavor, want it all. Only 17. Bet you know the trash I mean. Oh, yeah.
It's not here once again. You know, I was in my favourite supermarket the other day, breaking up a few shelves. And suddenly, lo and behold, I saw on a shelf, Action Yob. I mean, I knew I was famous, but I mean, golly, you know. I looked at the ingredients on the back of the packet, and it said, just wind up. And it nutcha. Oh! 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 Right!
Hillier, search suit here. Unfortunately, the revolution has had to be postponed, you know, due to the bend in Rod Stewart's nose. However, good news about it, when it does happen, you know, we are going to solve all your traffic problems. When we take over, there will be just one road from your house to the factory. One way.
Switch the recorder on now. So, you've decided to become a BG. don't touch that bottle. I'll tell you when to touch the bottles. Now, you puny little nobody, we'll begin to make you into a world-famous BG. First, you'll need the world-famous BG teeth. Now you can touch the bottles. Take one pill from bottle A. Not that one. Bottle A, you waste of space. The shirt open to the navel, exposing hairy chest and revealing large golden medallion pill. Or as I call it, bottle B. Ah, he's got the right bottle this time. Well done, little chap. Stage three, bottle C. You'll be needing the world famous BG hair. Look at you. Yes, not bad. But there's something missing. You're only one, and there should be three. Take bottle D. Now you'll need the most important part of a BG, the world-famous vibrato. Will you all pick up the vibrato bottles and keep taking the pills until the required wobble is achieved?
Watching every day go by, changing my life, changes your life, keeps us all anticipating. We are searchers of the truth. Every man's a god.
She stood in the street, smiling from my head to her feet. I said, hey, now, what is this? Now, baby, maybe, maybe she's in need of a kiss. I said, hey, what's your name, baby? Maybe we can see things the same. Now, don't you wait, oh, hesitate. Let's move. Home to my place, watching every move on her face. She said, look, what's your game, baby? Are you trying to put me in shape? I said, slow, don't go so fast. Don't you think that love can last? She said, love, love above. Now you're trying to trick me.
signals from the rocks above the pass. The cowboys take positions in the bushes and the grass. The score is with the corporal, she is tied against a tree. She doesn't mind the language, it's the beating she don't need. She lets loose all the horses when the corporal is asleep. And he wakes to find the fire's dead and arrows in his hats. And Davy Crockett rides around and says it's cool for cats, it's cool for cats. To go to catch a gang of villains in a shed up at Heathrow. They're counting out the fivers when the handcuffs lock again. In and out of once they put the numbers on their names. It's funny how the missus always looks to be the same. And meanwhile at the station there's a couple of likely lads who swear like as your father and they're very cool for cats. They're cool for cats. To change the mood a little I've been posing down the pub. I'll see you my reflection.
Viewers, Sid Snot here. I said to my bird Deirdre last night, "Here, Deird, your knickers are coming down." She said, "How do you know?" I said, "I just decided."
Faster than a speeding bullet. More powerful than a locomotive. Able to leap tall buildings at a single bound.
Up in the sky,
it's a bird.
It's a plane.
It's a man.
He sequins here, he sequins there. He throws his sequins everywhere. Tinselman.
Hi, I'm Tinselman, fighter of true causes and the cause of many fights. But what care I of fools and fortune? I'm here on your planet in your hour of need to make the world a prettier place. Yes. Thanks to my wonderfulness and my magic tinsel, here in the tinsel pouch, ugliness will disappear forever, and everything will just be Gucci poo. Oh, sounds like the bracelet phone. Hello, tinsel man. Oh, no, you're kidding. Oh, golly, sounds like a job for wonderful me. Down, down, and away. Oh, come on, Tinselman, pull yourself together. Ugly, ugly, drabby poos. Look at all those mucky shoes. To the tinsel pouch we scurry to transform them in a hurry.
The world should be pretty. And now to my next assignment.
He sequins here, he sequins there. He throws his sequins everywhere.
Oh, life is such a gay world for us superheroes. Oh no, something else. No rest for the wonderful.
Dragonsville! Soon fix this!
Ooh, better! Better! Now you can see. A lumpy bit!
Vegetable basketball here in any old street, any old tatty town to report sightings of falling tinsel. Millions of people have said this strange object zips out of the sky like a giant gold Brillo pad. Who is he? Where is he? Here is he!
Hi. Ordinary.
No!
Oh, much better. Bye.
He sequins here, he sequins there, he throws his sequins everywhere. Tinselman!
And remember, kiddies, if a job's well worth doing, it's a job well doing done or something. Well, I'm off now to clean up new filth and ugly nutty poo. And remember, we're all pretty under the skin. Except me, I'm pretty everywhere. Bye!
Tinselman!
Hey, baby, where's the beach?
Man, I'm gonna water ski. Where can I find some sloping sea? I can dig that.
What a decision. Which screen to look at? Oh, there you are. Hello. You know, lots of you have been writing in, you naughty creatures, saying, where did we find hot gossip? Well, we didn't find them. We made them. What we did is we got a lot of wrinkled little old ladies like this.
Come on, ladies. You'll love it in there. It's a great sketch. Wonderful.
Bunged them in the Throbotron like this.
Close the door. We pull the switch.
And out came this. And now they're doing this. It's so wonderful being a megastar. Walk into any shop and you'll see nowadays Kenny Everett t-shirts, Kenny Everett badges, Kenny Everett expanding doobries, and the latest in my galaxy of goodies, the Kenny ball. And you know, the nicest thing about my ball is that when you throw it up,
it doesn't come down.
And now a tune that was first recorded by whoever recorded it first. It's called I Go to Pieces by Rachel Sweet. I wonder if she's seen my ball.
When I see him walking down the street, I get so shaky and I feel so weak. I tell my eyes look the other way, but they don't listen to a word I say. And I go to pieces and I wanna cry. Go to pieces and I almost die every time my baby passes by.
Hi, thought about your knees lately. Do you keep them warm with our nifty natty kneecaps? Keep them fresh with our knees to knee powder for that personal under knee problem. You have? Good, because tonight I'm here to tell you about the big one. Yes, we've done it again. Another Kneesville breakthrough. It's extra knee for those moments when two knees just aren't enough. Ever asked your boss how you stand for a raise and he said, "You don't stand! You kneel!" Well, think of the impact of a three-knee kneel. Ever been turned down by that special someone when you've proposed? Well, what gal could resist a three-knee plea? Send now for your extra knee.
A knee for you and a knee for me. Another knee will make it three. See how happy you will be with extra knee.
Hear what only one satisfied customer had to say about extra knee. Mrs. Ethel Chloride writes, "Extra knee saved my life. On the way home from underwater bingo, a scuba mugger approached me, and I kneed him three times. Thanks, extra knee."
Knees are fun. Fun knee.
Yes, ladies and gentlemen, don't forget new miracle, extra knee. In heat and water resistant polycycrone with reciprocal alabaster joints and digital ball and socket functioning. Yes, extra knee is for you. It makes you a three you. You need extra knee.
See how happy you will be with extra knee.
Hey man, where's the surf? Lord Tem said he'd deliver. And that dude's got his own river. I didn't dig that much. Hello, eggheads everywhere. Isn't it boring being an egg? There's nothing to look forward to. I mean, poached, fried, scrambled, boiled. Oh, I think I'm cracking up.
Here's David Bowie.
Life is a pop of the cherry.
life and everything, you get your share. When you're a boy, hey! Boys, boys, boys keep swinging, boys always working out.
What are you doing in those trousers? And stop it, whatever it is! Look at you, lily-livered mincer. Do you know, I was in the war, but I didn't see you there. I fought for people like you, and I never got one. Look at you. Have a good mind to hit you with my umbrella, but I think you'd enjoy it. And why should you have all the fun? So why don't you hit me with yours? Go on, please. Go on, please. Now, chase me round and call me names.
Dance, man.
Take me, take me.
But seriously, folks, this is the moment you've all been waiting for. Can I have a roll on the drums, please? Thank you. Yes, it's the secret of life at last. The secret of life.
Here. Welcome to a show in a glass of its own.
Yes, Thames Television, the station with knockers. Excuse me, there's one now. Yes, can I help you?
Tamata wakatangi hangi kuweyu wo tamataya tuli pukaka piki monga hora luku boka wena wakatana tahu matakuwa tanga nuru kawa miki tora.
And what that really means is...
Did you know in Chicago a sister hocke susna snyder mit a stickle spons cake off an unknown side of Cincinnapolis, huh?
Yes, hallelujah, it's the video show. And now, the man the BBC calls... Hello, fan, and welcome to show 10. Yes, it's the show we've all been waiting for. The last one of the series. And what a show it's going to be. We've got 200 Romanian dentists. They'll be drilling for you. Norman the barefoot tap dancer. And we'll be revealing the true identity of the man in the mask. Remember him? And we'll be taking you over to Scotland Yard, where Shaw Taylor has been arrested for stealing stolen jewellery. Ain't that a kick in the head? Ow!
Hello, my little cheesecakes. I have a confession to make. I am a married man. But that does not stop me being aromantic. And to keep our romance alive in our marriage, every week, my wife and I have a meal in a little restaurant that we know. Candlelight, soft music, and really smoochy atmosphere. I go Wednesday, she goes Friday. Au revoir, my little bamboo shoots.
Did you hear about the Irish baby who refused to wear nappies? He said it took him too long to get them off when he wanted to go to the loo.
And now it's listen to attention time.
Hi, kids. Kremen here. You remember the tight spot we were in last time? Carla was standing alone on Brooklyn Bridge, trying to lure the giant Bonarner towards her.
Cooey,
Mr. Banana, over here!
Hidden behind a skyscraper, my trusty spaceship, Troll One, was ready to attack the fiendish creature.
We moved slowly into the firing line.
Prime photon bullets!
Photon bullets primed!
By the look on that banana's face, Doc, I'd say it liked Carla.
I think Carla likes the banana.
Engage Thrawn Banks!
Thrawn Banks engaged!
Quick, Captain! It's reaching down to her! Quick as a flash, I threw the ship into hyperdrive, shot out from behind the building, and...
Fire one! Fire two!
Two direct hits. The banana lurched to one side, groaning. Quick, Doc! Home in on Carla and pick her up!
Yeah, man, Captain!
With a soul-tearing groan, the banana finally keeled over and fell headlong into the Hudson.
NBC News, Milton Thrin reporting. Teams of navvies have been employed to drag the wounded banana to dry land. Then, with the aid of hundreds of mobile tower cranes, take it to New York City Hospital, where a team of surgeons led by Dr. Heinrich von Gitfinger are operating on this weird creature even now.
Carla and I were back at the offices of StarCorp, patting each other on the back.
Down a bit. Yeah, up a bit.
Have I got it?
Well, Captain.
What?
Reports are coming in from all over saying there's enough fruit and vegetables to feed the whole world forever.
I know, that's wonderful, Carla. Ah, Doctor, did you manage to save the banana?
Well, it was touch and go for a while, but eventually it pulls through.
Well, that's wonderful, Doc. Any problems?
Well, there is just one itsy-bitsy one.
What's that?
I'm afraid that even though the banana is still alive, it will always be a cabbage.
Well, that's another nasty situation neatly tucked away, Carla.
Yeah, you've saved the world again.
Yeah. But you know, I always hate it when an adventure comes to an end.
Oh, why is that?
Because it means I gotta think of a whole new one for next week.
Hello, Sid Snot here. Me and my bird Deirdre had an argument last night. She said our pad ain't got enough furniture. So I bought her a beautiful straight back chair. She sits in it. Trouble is, she won't plug it in.
Hello, I'm David Essex's right eyeball, and I've just popped out to say hello. My name's Iris, and you can't get cornier than that. Oh dear, better go now. David's just walked into the wall.
planter. 20 planter.
Time to reveal the secret identity of the man in the mask. You remember a few weeks ago in the video vault, we showed an old clip of an unknown singer. Well, thousands of you wrote in saying it was David Soul, but you were wrong. In fact, only three of you were right. Well done. Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to play you now a lovely record. It's sold 16 million copies and it's never been on telly before, even though it's a golden oldie. It's Nights in White Satin by the Moody Blues, and it's such a lovely record that you don't really need to see it on the screen. You can just close your eyes and listen. And think of the money we'll save on sets.
In white satin, never reaching the end. Letters I've written, never mean to send. Beauty I'd always missed with these eyes before. Just what the truth is, I can't say it anymore. I love you. Yes, I love you. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Tell me thoughts they cannot defend. Just what you want to be, you will be in the end. And I'll love you. We'll be right back.
Everett looks at the camera and speaks. He seems to be stressing that intrinsic non-communication that bedevils communication, and yet at the same time, he seems to be saying, why communicate? And yet...
Commercial time.
Hello. Ever thought what a bore it is cooking a meal? Stuck in the kitchen, surrounded by heavy, ugly machinery. Cookers, ovens, pots and pans, skillets and grills. Well, they're all things of the past now, thanks to our new futuristic super product, electric meat.
It's sweet, yum, yum. It's neat, yum, yum. It's ever such a treat. Yum,
yum. Electric meat? Yes, as inconceivable as it may seem, I'm actually standing here in the kitchen of tomorrow. Thanks to electric meat, all we need now are these simple, easy-to-operate wall plugs. Electric meat comes ready to cook. All you do is plug it in, and it's ready to eat in minutes.
It's sweet, yum, yum. It's neat, yum, yum. It's ever such a treat. Yum,
yum. Electric meat. It's delicious. Next time you're in your local supermarket, remember electric meat. It's AC or DC. Also works from batteries for those lovely family picnics.
It's sweet. Yum, yum. It's neat. Yum, yum. It's ever such a treat. Yum,
yum. Remember, all you do is plug it in. Electric meat. It's neat.
Yum, yum.
Agamemnon, etc. Hello, welcome to the video vault here in the bowels of Thames Television House, where we're going to show you a whoopee poor rooty. Yes, we're going back in the annals of time to show you something hot and steaming from the very first video show. It's hot gossip. Yes, from the beginning of Naughtiesville, we bring you the very first thing they ever did.
Supernature. Supernature. Supernature.
Well, that's it. The end of the show and the end of the series. Next Monday night at 7, we won't be here. Who knows what that could mean? Will Crossroads collide with Coronation Street? Will Monday show up at all? And who cares? Because now at last, in the dying seconds of this dying video show, we bring you The Secret of Life! Yes, here in this little china box, which we found next to the Dead Sea Scrolls among some old Max Bygrave scripts, is the answer to everything. I'll just open it up now.
Dummy, if you can't take care of the box, how can I trust you with my secret?
Hello, creeps. Sid Snot here. You know, I don't know why that Kelly and him is always going on about the secret of life. I mean, we all know what the secret of life is, don't we? Bit of aggro, knuckle sandwich, mouth full of dandruff, chat up a tasty bit, and away on the toes. Big secret.
Hello, my little gem butties. You know, it is the last video show on Monday. So it is time to put everything away and do the nutty French strip first of all. Da 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 da. Yes, it was me all the time.